Hey, welcome back. Today on the road, we're going to be talking about the agreement that members of a band have. Let's get to it. My name's Todd Nelson. I'm a musician. I'm an educator. I'm someone who's helped bands for a long, long time. So if you like what you see here today, please go ahead and subscribe and leave comments below afterwards. So, when we talk about an agreement among band members, what does that mean exactly? What I'm talking about when I talk about the agreement among band members is that anytime that you join a group, there is sometimes an implied relationship that occurs. But often it's more of an implication and it's not really spelled out. And I think this is a big problem for a lot of bands that try to start to get together, and one person thinks that the band's going to be about this, and the other member thinks it's going to be about that. Let me give you an example. I went to an audition for a band. It was going to be a hard rock band, cover band, playing in the clubs. Went in for the audition and killed it. Just played like a monster. Felt really good about it. I liked all the guys in the band. They were terrific. They could all play their butts off. The singer had a great voice. And we started to talk about immediately as soon as the audition was done. They said, yeah, we'd really love for you to play with us. And I said, cool, this is going to be great. And so we went on upstairs to the living room where we were going to start discussing the details. And these guys decide to pull out the bong and start to get stoned. That's fine, but that's not where I'm coming from. I mean, everybody remembers college, but if we're going to be out playing in a gig, that's not where I'm at anymore. And that wasn't ever spelled out beforehand when we got into it. So for me, that was a deal breaker. I didn't want to have to be in a band where I'm worried about whether they're going to be able to execute their parts or not. So that's a good example of where in the negotiation process, that should have been spelled out. What do you guys think about partying? Do you do it? Do you don't do it? What do you want to try to get out of the band here? When you get into an agreement with a band, there's a couple things that happen. First of all, you're agreeing that you're going to have each other's back. You're going to play together, that you're going to have everybody's best interest when you get out there on stage. And so when you get out there on stage and you start playing, the thing that you're going to try to do is to put on the best performance, and you're going to try to make the guy next to you look good, whether he's the lead singer, the guitar player, the drummer. You're going to try to make them look good. You're not going to be flipping them off and giving them dirty looks and doing all sorts of foolishness that is not to everybody's interest. So there's this agreement. And the more explicit that agreement is going in, the better off the band is, especially when it comes to things like money and travel and time commitment. All of those things are things that have to be spelled out pretty dang clearly. Otherwise, you're going to get people really pissed off. How many days a week are you going to practice or perform? Is it one? Is it two? Is it three? Are you going to go on the road? Well, how much are you going to go on the road? Do other people have jobs? What takes precedent over your job? Those are things you need to spell out clearly on paper so there is no misunderstanding about it. And then more so, after those things are all spelled out, you need to know and hear it in words that people are like, yes, I can agree 100% with this agreement. That agreement, when it gets spelled out, makes a huge difference. I mean, huge difference to the overall success of the band. So I hope that you can, the next time you go into a negotiation with getting into a group, or even if you have a group now and you're like, something's going on, we've got problems with the group, we've got to figure things out, it might be time to sit down and to reestablish what are your agreed upon details of how the band's going to function and what are you going to do with the band. So go ahead, get that detail out, and know that your band is going to be better off for it. So question of the day is, what kinds of agreements have you guys had in the bands that you've played in? And then also, if you could leave your comments below about a story about when it didn't go so well because of a misunderstanding of what the band was supposed to be. Leave those below. And please subscribe to the channel here. Hit the bell on your way out here. We'll see you next time on the road for the Better Band.